Ethical veganism has been ruled as a philosophical belief that should be protected against workplace discrimination, that those embracing it were entitled to similar protection as those who held religious beliefs. The man behind this is Jordi Casamitjana, who has been an ethical vegan since his early adult life. He grew up with a passion for animals, made the transition a little bit later to full-on veganism, aka cute, cuddly, animal lover, now working as a zoologist specializing in animal behavior. Not that type of animal behavior. So Jordi was fired when he told his colleagues that their pension fund was being invested in companies that experiment on animals. So he sought out to prove that veganism is a philosophical or religious belief, and therefore a protected characteristic, meaning it is no lawful grounds for discrimination similar to race, religion, and pregnancy. These are the criteria: be genuinely held, be a belief as to a weighty and substantial aspect of human life and behavior, attain a certain level of cogency, seriousness, cohesion, and importance, be worthy of respect in a democratic society, not to be incompatible with human dignity and not conflict with the fundamental rights of others, be a belief, not an opinion or viewpoint based on the present state of information available. How would you argue that a vegan diet fits into any of these things? I mean, vegans do an excellent job at lying to people, but considering that a vegan diet literally kills people, maims young babies and children, how can you justify it to be compatible with human dignity, and that it does not conflict with the fundamental rights of others? And it is certainly not a belief. It is literally an opinion of the present state of information available. You are presented with the modern day propaganda, fear-mongering, conventional wisdom that sucked you into veganism in the first place. Oh my god, did you see Cowspiracy? It is so sad. How is that a belief? Who gets to decide what is right and wrong? This judge apparently thinks he can. Either way, this story doesn't add up. We don't know exactly why they fired him. They claim it was gross misconduct surrounding a different incident. Maybe we were right. Clearly, there is part of the story they aren't sharing. Maybe he tried to organize the other vegan employees into some type of protest. I absolutely understand the love that vegans have for animals. If anything, I love them just as much myself as you vegans roll your eyes. But the moral belief is no excuse for dismissing the importance of animal nutrition in human life. That is, if their moral belief was correct. Vegans are simply choosing to kill insects and small animals in conventional agriculture as opposed to larger animals. It's a bit of a disconnect with reality. Unless you work on a farm, familiarize yourself with conventional agriculture, you don't realize how the ecosystem is affected by monocropping, from all of the agrochemicals to the physical tilling of the soil. If you think about it, there is no legitimate, intelligent reason to go vegan, for the animals is a lie, and these people are bombarded with nonsense documentaries, propaganda, telling them more lies about their health, about the environment. We do not live in a truthful society. If that was the case, I wouldn't be talking about this stuff every single day. I wouldn't be losing my mind. One of my viewers suggested that this will only lead to suffering for those who do not believe in a vegan diet. And this is absolutely right. But vegans are suffering themselves as well. There are, of course, other religions that restrict their diet at certain periods of time, but not to the point of starving children and maiming babies. Worth mentioning that humans have been fighting wars and killing each other as long as we have been around, religion being another reason to add fuel to that fire. They are pitting us against each other. They are putting special interest shills, corporate-funded people, to make sure men are fighting against women, that blacks are fighting against whites, that carnivores are fighting against vegans, and it's all being controlled by the puppeteers in charge of our society, and they're doing a great job at suppressing people like me who are actually trying to help people. As much as I would like to believe there is some good in this world, there is far too much evil acting in parasitic nature. The most dangerous part about this instance specifically is that it will restrict speaking negatively about veganism. Just another way to censor our free speech. Granted, it is specific to the workplace as it was judged by an employment tribunal. If anything goes against modern culture, what they want us to believe, it's labeled as a conspiracy theory and you get thrown in jail for it. America is the land of the sheep who believe they are wolves. The craziest thing to me is that these vegans are brainwashed into promoting this movement for a false cause. Just like every single person you go to, oh, I coughed twice, I gotta go see a doctor. Oh, I threw up, I gotta take 9 rounds of antibiotics and destroy my gut microbiome. Appeal to authority, MDs, doctors. Not all of these people are evil, but most of them are. The reasons to go vegan are meaningless. You were either fear-mongered into it with propaganda, have a low enough IQ to believe it, are a cute, cuddly animal lover, oink, oink, or have special interest bias. The amount of corporate shills controlled by conventional agriculture is despicable. And these people have one thing in common. They're ignoring me, for the most part, or they're steering you away from me. And that's because these people will not talk about certain topics. Special interest funding. I have pointed out all of the carnivore special interest funding. Vegans will not touch it with a 10-foot pole because they are funded themselves. They will not talk about Wi-Fi and EMF. They will not talk about climate. They will not tell you the truth because these are the things that the elite don't want you to know because, like myself, you will become more intelligent and more aware of what is really going on. Guys, I never thought I'd get to the point where I was thinking about giving up, but I really hate to say this, but it's becoming reality because, you know, there are so many people telling lies about me. There's people plagiarizing my information, gaslighting people, astroturfing, gang stalking. I am under attack by corporate special interest, and on one hand, I am, you know, fearful for my own well-being. It's horrible how the sheep of the population will become their own worst enemy, and I don't really know what to do at this point, you know? I make jokes all the time about escaping to a farm with some, like, hot Russian girl and enjoying my life, and, you know, what's the point anymore? There are certainly good people out there, but most of them are wolves in sheep's clothing. Every single carnivore diet influencer, you don't get on Joe Rogan, guys. I guarantee you, Joe has been bothered about me more than anyone else in the past few months. And I will never be on that podcast. And you know why. You know exactly why. Every single carnivore influencer that you've heard of, for the most part, is special interest funded, Facebook groups, Reddit forums. Good people out there? Yes. In the carnivore community, not one that I know of. I mean, I guess this video took a pretty dramatic turn from what I was intending on talking about, but whatever. If you guys want to support me, check out my book, Ancestral Indigenous Diet, down in the description below. Guys, most important thing you can do is share the video, you know, subscribe, like the video, all that good stuff. Check out the other videos on my channel. But thank you guys for joining me. I'm going to try not to have a stroke.